Okay, hi everyone.
Hi.
As Manshu already introduced, getting forward to it. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for being here. So I appreciate the patience for that. And I would like to thank the KOSS team for selecting me as a mentor and giving me the chance to stood against you people and speak my little bit story about me. So you people already have done many projects and you all are experienced, you must be experienced. But maybe my story can help you in something in your life. So this is my topic, my journey. My journey from being a medical aspirant towards GSoC 2017. As it mentions, I was having biology in my higher secondary school. So, but I was having interest in coding and all. So I always tried to code at school time and after that also, but due to high pressure of handling biology and pressures from parents, you can say. So I didn't code much at that time. After that, there are a lot of mistakes I made. So the first slide says my deviation towards computer science. So I always was interested in exploring new technical things and all. Which motivated me for the computer science was I used to play GTA San Andreas. Okay, so I always wanted to make a game like that. I didn't my approach was not like as a game programmer, but it was like it arose the interest of computer science in myself. So that was the main driving force that motivated me for the computer science. So after what mistakes I have made in my life, after selecting biology, maybe you can say pressure or due to some ambiguous goals, like was not clear about what exactly I was doing, what exactly was my goal. So I took biology and after that I prepared for medical entrance examinations. And apart from preparing for the medical exams, I took two or three more things simultaneously. I'm not saying it's bad, but you should be focused on one goal. Like, you should not be spreading your legs on two boats that are going to be different destinations. So this was the main mistake I made, and due to that I landed not into some reputed college, but I didn't give up. I didn't lost my hope in that. So what was the thing I was doing apart from preparing for medical examinations was I was preparing for engineering also, and I appeared for improvement exams also. I got 81% marks in the first attempt, of course. But I again tried for the improvement examination and the focus was, you can say, was ambiguous. I tried for DU also. I got admission in DU Ramlalan College also for computer science honors. But then I thought I should do BTech because I am having keen interest in computer science. So these were the mistakes I made, and what you can say, the things I learned from my mistakes, these are the things. Always plan your goals in life. Don't be ambiguous about your future decisions. It should be towards one destination. Like what I was doing was preparing for medical and engineering, that was not good. That was just opposite directions. And I'm not saying people can't do that, people do these things, but you should not focus on both these destinations. These are the things I learned from these mistakes and my journey. Now after I got admission in BTech Engineering College, BTech College, for the BTech course, I was unaware of what coding is. I was having interest in software development, but having just what you can say, doesn't know the ABC of coding. So then I encountered this C. C language was the first language I encountered in the second semester. So I was like, I didn't know anything about it. And my friends were like, they are the master of coding. They have studied computer science in 12th, so in higher secondary. So they were like, they were just typing it, and I was just looking at the code, what is it like, and just understanding what actually it is. And from that, I never gave up. This is the main quality I learned from my mistakes. I never gave up. After that, I appeared for many things. I worked hard. I have done many projects. I have appeared in Smart India Hackathon for the Android projects. I have done GSoC, Google Summer of Code. There is also a story behind Google Summer of Code also, but due to lack of time, I will not be interpreting that. So, what motivated me for the open source? You know what? A guy who gave the talk at the I guess on the second term, he said that main motto is getting money. Okay. So I will give you one more thing which can motivate you to that open source development. First thing was like I always wanted to be an IPS officer because I always wanted to do something for the society. The main thing you can do for by contributing to open source is you can always, you are giving free software to the society, so you are doing something for the society. It gives self-satisfaction. I think that will be enough to motivate you people for the open source development, right? And obviously GSoC has many perks like cool stipends, cool certificates, Google tags, obviously. But you should always keep in mind that you are doing something for the society. These softwares will be available for the society for free of cost, and these are developed by brilliant minds like you. So this can be the motto for that. Now, according to the technologies, I will just give a brief intro about yeoman generator. These were the technologies I worked on, and I will just give you a brief intro about yeoman generator, what actually it is. How many of you have worked on web apps? Okay, so are you familiar with yeoman generators? Node.js. It comes under NPM. So what actually yeoman generator is, like if you are developing many web apps for your organization, you have to just copy all those things and then paste it. After that you are starting creating some new things on that. Like you should have some structure built of web app. After that you can start coding on that. So yeoman generator provides a platform. It scaffolds a web app which can be similar to the building scaffolding. Like you are first providing the structure and then you are building the main part on that. So it provides that construction for you. How it works and what is the use of it? You will ask that I can just copy many times as I can. But the main advantage of this is you can select between technologies. Like you have one yeoman generator and you can input 4 to 5 technologies like AngularJS, ReactJS, anything you want. And after selecting, you can also provide inputs to your different modules. If you are copying one part of code to the other, you have to copy that, like here we have this name, a particular name. You have to copy that into different modules. That can be easily done by yeoman generator. It can be just provided through the inputs. So I'm just giving a demo about that. What you need to do is, first of all, you have to install the node, then npm version, check the npm version by this command. Okay, shows the version, that means npm has been successfully installed in your computer. So now what you have to do is npm install global view. From that, you can install the yeoman generator globally into the system. It's already installed, and for generating, for installing the generators plugins for that, we have to do this like this. Generator-generator. That's it what we have to do for installing yeoman generator plugins. After that, you just have to type the command yo generator into a directory, and then you will be having a structure like this. These all are automatically generated by the yo generator command. After that, what you have to do, I have already prepared due to less time. So what you have to do is, you have to go into generators, then app, then we have this, these things. Templates, where we have package.json, and I have created a sample project for that. Now what we have to do is, we have the generator, and now we have to link that. Now we have to link to the NPM so that we can generate our web app from that. For that we have to do this. Just type the yo command and type the generator name. For this I have generator yoman demo. After typing you will be redirected to a project. Like if I do this. Yes, you will be asked for the inputs. This is what I am talking about. Like if you are copying one structure to the other, you will not be asked for this. You have to copy everything, the name from one module to the other module, and many modules if you have, you have to copy into each module. So like, these are the questions I have answered it. No,